had quite a few health issues throughout my life. Most of them stem from a diagnosis of type 1 diabetes when I was 9 years old, and that was back in 1973. In 1983, at the age of 19, I lost my sight, so I am totally blind. So if you have any questions or comments or anything, please just shut them off because I won't see your hands. And then in 1994, I was diagnosed with end-stage renal failure. I was put on dialysis for 6 months, and at that time they realized that that dialysis would not be a long-term solution for me. So on May 9th, 1995, I was given the chance of life by my sister-in-law, Tammy, donating one of her kidneys to me and gave me a chance to live on. And then, like I said, in 2003, I had a pancreas transplant. I was put on the waiting list because even though my diabetes was under really good control, I was still having some complications. So I was on the waiting list for 6 weeks, and then I finally got that magical call. It was on December 5th, 2003. I'll never forget it. It was 10 o'clock at night. I was watching ER. That's the show that George Clooney became famous for. And I got the call from the transplant team saying they had a pancreas for me. And I asked, do you know anything about the donor? And they said, well, all we know is it's a 40-year-old woman from Florida. And my first thought was 40. Wow, that's kind of old. And then it dawned on me, I was going to be 40 in 3 months. So while this family grieving the loss of their loved one was making the decision to donate her organs, they gave me a pancreas to help save my life so I could spend more time with my family. And that's what I really did. Then things were going along pretty well. And then in 2009, I was told I was going through end-stage renal failure again. My doctor said to me, Stacy, you better start looking for a living donor, because we had already realized that dialysis was not a long-term solution for me, and I would never make it 5 years on the waiting list. So I told everybody I knew about my need for a kidney. I had over a dozen people tested. I should have been a fairly easy match, but only one person matched, and that was my husband, Wayne, luckily. So on July 16, 2009, we had our transplant, and Wayne gave me one of his kidneys, and my life was saved again. Without the generosity and the kindness of these donors, both family and a complete stranger, I wouldn't have been able to buy my first home with a big backyard in it, adopt 6 wonderful puppies that I love and adore, and they're the best in the world. I wouldn't have been able to meet several unbelievable people all across the country because I've been sharing my story with them. I wouldn't have been able to write 6 children's books. I wouldn't have celebrated my 50th birthday. I wouldn't have had 21 more years of marriage with a wonderful man, my husband Wayne, and I wouldn't be here today to share my story with you. So as you can see, organ donation is very important. And I'd like to thank you all for giving me the chance to share my story. And I hope that you all think about registering to be an organ donor if you haven't already. It's really easy. The next time you go in to do your driver's license or state ID, just check the box. Or you can always go to donatelifemn.org and sign up right online. Thanks for your time.